Hey everyone, in this video, I'm gonna show you how to use the new Affinity by Canva. I made this video right here where I go over all the tools on the vector side. And in this video, I'm gonna show you how to actually use it to create something. And the something we're gonna make is a very simple t-shirt design. So I'm gonna show you kind of very basic things. I will make more videos on how to make more detailed t-shirts, but in this video, I wanna get you started, show you the very basics of it, and you can use it to create t-shirts to sell online. So I'm gonna go step by step on how to find what to sell online, kind of the really quick research. And then we're gonna build it in Affinity Designer and it will be ready to sell on Amazon. I'm gonna actually put it on some t-shirts on Amazon Merch On Demand. So lots to see in this video. Hopefully it's really helpful so you can see how the tools work in Affinity. All right, I'm here on Amazon first to do some research on funny t-shirts. So I'm gonna type in here, funny t-shirts, just like that. And I have an app or I have a plugin from Chrome called DS Amazon Quick View that will show me kind of the sales of it, or at least the BSR right here. So BSR is the bestseller rank. The lower the number, the better it is. So a rank of number one is the best selling product on Amazon over everything. Now t-shirts usually get a little higher. Anything under 500,000 is really, really good. Even 645,000 is pretty good. That's how competitive t-shirt sales are. But I just typed in funny t-shirts. You'll notice this one right here is just a text t-shirt. That's funny. And it has 27,000 BSR bestseller rank. And that's really good compared to like this, right? So this is 800,000, this is 27,000. The lower the number, it sells exponentially better. So you can see even text t-shirts do really well. I'm gonna try and see if there's other text t-shirts. Yep, and that's the easiest one to do in Affinity Designer. So I think we'll just do that for this one. I'm gonna say, if you met my family, you'd understand. That's funny. So that one's getting pretty low. Now, you don't wanna copy these, you wanna make your own, but maybe you can use these as a reference. So I'm gonna go to ChatGPT, and I'm just gonna copy this right here. Let's see if I can. Copy right there. And I'm gonna go to ChatGPT, and so I just typed in, make me 10 other funny phrases for t-shirts, like this phrase, if you met my family, you'd understand. I'm gonna hit this. And this way you are not copying exactly the phrase. Now you'll still have to run these through trademark check, but let's just pick one of these. I'm not arguing, I'm just explaining why I'm right. Of course, I talk to myself sometimes, I need expert advice. So lots of funny phrases here. I like this one. I put the pro in procrastinate. So let's do that. I'm gonna take that phrase and copy it, just scroll over it and Command C, and then now I'm gonna open up Affinity Designer. I'm gonna paste it in there and let's kinda use what's in Affinity Designer to make it look a little better, not just one line of text. All right, so I'm here in Affinity. I think I said Affinity Designer in the last one, but it's actually all three together. So Designer is now Vector in here, Pixel was Affinity Photo, and layout was Affinity Publisher. Now it's just a lot easier and you can see it and they're all together. You don't have to open up separate apps and all of that. First thing I'm gonna do is go to File and New. We're gonna start a new one. I already made this as my preset. I showed how to do this in my other video, so you can watch that. But basically, you can put it here and type in or change what you need here. I have this as 4,500 by 5,400, which is the size you would need if you wanna create t-shirt designs for Amazon, which is what we're doing. And I'm just gonna hit create document with this selected. You can, if you don't have this preset, can put these numbers in and then hit create document. And we got it right here. The next thing I'm gonna do is use the text tool. So we're gonna come in here, the text tool in Vector. So for some reason it defaults to Pixel. I can't remember how to do that, but make sure you change to Vector here. We're just gonna use the Vector Studio and the tools in here. I'm not gonna use all of these, but I'm gonna use some of them. The first thing I'm gonna use is the text one, Artistic Text Tool. Click on that, click in here, and do the Command V after you copied your text here, and I'm gonna make it bigger here. You can see I put the pro and procrastinate. So I'm gonna click here. Oh, make sure you're on the move tool and then move this around. I'm gonna actually copy it and do option, click, drag so that I have another one, just so I have this up here. I wanna put, I put the pro in procrastinate. I'm gonna make, since procrastinate is a longer word, I'm gonna copy this again, click on it, option, click, drag. Well, defaulted to the text. Make sure you're on this black arrow, I like to call it. Click on it, option, click, drag. I'm gonna click on this and make sure that this is just procrastinate. Now, since it's a longer word, I'm gonna pick a type that's more condensed. And one of my favorites is this font called Veneer. Now, I bought it from Yellow Design Studios online, and I just put it on my computer, and it's already here as one of my favorites. So I didn't have to load it onto Affinity. Affinity just grabs all the fonts that are on my computer. And it's right here, Veneer and Veneer Clean. I'm just gonna do Veneer right there. And you can see if I click on it, it is Veneer. So I'm gonna grab the corner here again and drag it and use the black arrow again and kind of put it right there. Now, I'm gonna use this same font. So I'm gonna drag this up, option, click, drag up. I'm gonna put, I put the, maybe that is what we want. Option, click, drag down, pro, we'll do the quotes, pro in. Now to make this look, just to have a little more style, I'm gonna get rid of these because we have all the words we need. So I'm clicking on here and deleting with the arrow, click on here and delete. And I'm gonna make these bigger. I put, and I'm making it bigger by grabbing the corner here and dragging while in the, with the arrow tool, or the, what do we call this? The move tool, right? And there, I'm gonna make it so that it's lined up like this. And then we're gonna do procrastinate, maybe the same, like that. Now, one way to help you know that it's the same width is with guides. Now, guides are not on here. You usually have a ruler here and you can drag the guides from the ruler. So let's see, I believe it's in view and we got guides here, but I think I need to show rulers. There it is. So you go to view, show, and rulers, which is command R, and then just drag it from here, boom. Now, showing guides should be defaulted. You can see view guides or show guides right there. If I hit command and semicolon, it would go away, but, or click on this and you can see the guides would go away, but I actually wanna show the guide. So go back and show guides. Now, the nice thing about the guides is I can line everything up against those guides. So I can go like this and go like this, and then I'm gonna drag another guide to the end of this E here, and then I can take the, with the arrow tool or move tool, move these so that they're exactly on the right thing. Good. Okay, and I can remove these guides too, so I can just grab these and like throw them to the side if I don't need them anymore, or I could just not show the guides like we just showed. Good, so I think that's great. Another thing I like to do is make sure that this is centered. So you can see I put this on here, align horizontal center. If you don't see yours up here, which you probably don't, you'll have to right click on here, customize your toolbar, and add it to here. So I actually just did all this horizontal right here. So you don't need to do this one by one. You can do all of the align and they're all here. So that's what I'm gonna use. I'm gonna make sure that it's centered in there. See, it wasn't centered. I can do this and this one. Good. Now, I think this could work on a t-shirt. If you want to use a different font, you can. That's a nice thing to make it look a little different, is you can change the font on here. Yeah, so that's it. That's really, really simple. We have these all on these layers. I didn't really use any of these, any of the other ones besides the text tool and the move tool. So super easy for this tutorial. The thing that you're gonna wanna know is to export this. And typically we saw this on a black t-shirt with white text. So I'm gonna change it up a little bit. I'm gonna change this to yellow, a different color. So your color palette should be over here. And I like to work in CMYK. So I think by default, it's one of these other ones. Make sure it's on CMYK. And that's because you wanna use CMYK for printing, and we're gonna print a t-shirt. So I'm gonna just turn this to yellow for now. I have all of them selected with the tool, the move tool, right? And I'm gonna select the artboard one like this, and I'm gonna change the background to black. All right, now we could leave it yellow. I think that would be a cool t-shirt, but I'm gonna just change it to white here. So you can see 0000, all white. Now, if I wanna export this, you used to be able to hit Command Shift Option S, and that doesn't do it anymore. I don't know why, but Command Shift Option W does pull up export. But one thing that I found out, and I don't know if this is a bug or not, is that for PNG here, it doesn't knock it out. Let me show you what I mean. So I'm gonna cancel here, and I'm gonna remove the background from the artboard. So there's no background. All right, so here's the tricky part that I found. So normally you could click on the artboard one here and do Command Shift Option W, and you pull up the export. And if you go to PNG, you'll notice you can't see the transparent background for, I don't know why. It could be a bug, or it could be something that I'm missing here, but every version of PNG that I pick here is not showing the transparent background. So what I did find though, if I cancel this, is there is an export PNG up here. So make sure that you have your artboard selected. Hit export PNG up here. I'm gonna cancel this. Actually, if you click on this carrot right there, you will see that it is transparent on here. Right here that it's showing that it's transparent. So, and we have artboard one selected, which is what you want, PNG. And I'm gonna just hit export. And now you can see artboard one. We're just gonna do test or procreate, let's do that, procrastinate, dark on a dark t-shirt. I'm gonna hit save. And it's gonna go to my desktop. You might've seen that I selected desktop. And I'm gonna double click on this to show you what it looks like. And there it is. It's just the white text, not the background of it. So this is what we want to put on our t-shirt on Amazon Merch on Demand. So if you're seeing the same problem as I did with export, and it's exporting it all white and not the text in white, try this export PNG instead in the top right. Or let me know if you figured out any of the settings. Maybe I have some of the settings wrong, but this export PNG seems to be working as long as you have the artboard selected, and where you want to go is the desktop. Now you could put it anywhere on your computer, but I like desktop. It seems really easy. So I'm gonna stop that. And then now that we have the design, I'll show you how to put it on Amazon Merch on Demand if you have an account like that, and what it looks like on t-shirts. All right, so here we are on Amazon Merch on Demand. I'm in my account. I'm just gonna show you how easy it is to do this. If you can sign up for Amazon Merch on Demand or any POD really, like TeePublic and Redbubble, it kind of works the same way. I'm just gonna drag in the PNG that I made, the transparent PNG where I can see the white text, and put it right in here. So from my desktop, I'm dragging it right there, and it's the right size here. It's 4500 by 5400, and it's a PNG format, so, and it's less than 25. So I'm gonna open it up here. And by the way, we worked in CMYK, but anytime you save as a PNG, it will be an RGB color. So know that as well. So RGB 8 bits channel, we did that. Okay, so I can come in here and then pick some of the colors. So look, it fits perfectly in there. I can pick the dark colors. It won't work on some of these light colors, but that's why I would do this in black and then put it on the light colors. I already selected all of these. You can pick fit types, you can pick different products. The only one that I think wouldn't work is this raglan because they don't have dark raglans yet. But sweatshirt, hoodie, zip hoodie. Now, if you need it to be bigger on the hoodie, you can. You can change the size of it and center it with this right here. Pick the dark colors again, and it totally works. On these, they don't default to dark, so you're gonna have to come in here and pick the dark color really easy. Make it fit in here. Same thing with these ones. You can come in here, pick the dark color. Come in here, pick the dark color. I wish it would know like we're putting something in dark or give us the option to save the dark color at least. But one little extra step here, not too bad. This is pillows, square pillows, and you can do that too, and tumblers. So then you would come down here and type in your title, your brand, bullets, and description. And that's how easy it is to do POD on Amazon if you're able to get in. And once you do all that, you'll hit publish. And it will go to Amazon and you can sell this t-shirt if anybody buys it for, let's see, the price that we set. For $13.99, you'll get 45 cents. If you priced it at $20.99, you'll get $5.63 and all the other prices in between those. So the lower you go, the lower your, like if you go $19.99, you get $4.89 and so on. So I like to price it low first, try to get some sales, and then raise it up to about $19, $20. Once it starts selling, getting 5 to 10 sales already, and then, you know, that way it gets some rank, that BSR, that bestseller rank, and then you can mark it up a little bit. So there you go. That's how easy it is to do this. We did it in just a few minutes. So there you go, super easy tutorial in Affinity. I just wanted to show you a couple of tools there, and that's all you really need to know to start making t-shirts or designs in Affinity by Canva with the vector tools. Now I'm gonna do more tutorials that are slightly harder. Affinity doesn't have graphics embedded, so I'll have to find graphics or make graphics with the shapes and things with either with Canva or with Canva AI, I can make graphics, but I wanted to show you that you don't need to even know all of that. You can make a simple text t-shirt really easy and get yourself learning and growing and starting off. So the best thing to do is just to start and make something really simple, and that's what this tutorial is about. If you wanna see what those other tools do, you can look at this video right here that I did of all the tools on the side for the vector. And then I'll be making more videos for the other ones as well, pixel and layout, so you can learn that. But hopefully this video is really helpful. Thanks again for watching. And as always, keep creating and keep learning. I'll see you on the next one.